Well, there it goes. The Winnebago is on its way to its new home with Chris and Molly. And
they were so nice
to bring me a bottle of bourbon. Eagle Rare. Oh, I'm so looking forward to this. It's going to a good home, that's for sure. Hope they enjoy it. Many years of happy memories to them.
So this is our life. Four kids, two cats, a widowed father under our roof, and a dog named Booker. How do we make it through? The sunny days. This is life through our eyes.
Get the new travel trailer
in Indiana.
So there are some very good reasons we drove all the way to Indiana to get this travel trailer. This one has the heated and insulated underbelly so we can do more cold weather camping. It has a 10 cubic foot fridge instead of the stock 6 cubic foot one. It has a small dinette for one of the bottom rear bunk beds, 15k BTU AC. It has a side compartment that was used for external fridge and grill that happens to fit our 3500 watt generator perfectly, along with rear bumper and side compartment free plumb propane connector hookups. Got a power tongue jack, external shower. The slideout has two small windows on the sides of the slideout as well. Solar panel and inverter prep with roof port already installed and inverter wiring already run from the circuit panel. You'll see more of that in the next video when I go through the upgrades we're doing. And the biggest reason of all, the interior. Oh, the interior. Wait until you see the interior. Okay, so I had to clean this place up a little bit. What happens when you purchase a brand new RV is you go to turn on the air conditioning for the first time and you get this confetti shower full of sawdust coming out of the vents. It happened once at the dealership already. They had to vacuum it out. And driving back 8 hours over some bumpy roads in the shakedown period, it happened again. It was pretty messy. I mean, it's just from the manufacturing facilities. They're building these things in an assembly line. They're cleaning them up to the best of their abilities, but you still have to do that with every single new RV, it seems like. So I went ahead and did that, and now it's the part I think you've all been waiting for. The interior, right? Here you go.